Hi, hello, welcome to Maths Guru channel. In this video, I am going to explain exercise 5.3, 8th question. 8th question is, here's Arif took a loan of 80,000 from a bank. Okay, if the rate of interest is 10% per annum, find the difference in amounts he would be paying after 1.5 years. Okay, if the interest is compounded annually, the compounded half yearly and compounded half yearly. Okay, here interest is compounded annually and compounded half yearly. Annual means 1 year, half yearly means 6 months. See here, 1.5 year, no? Okay, now we should find out the compound interest for 1.5 year. Okay, here principal amount is given, rate of interest R is given, okay, T time also given. So simply we should use the formula, simple interest I is equal to PTR by 100. That we should use and we should get. Still it is there. See how we should find out. See, all this is the given information. I is equal to PTR by 100. So P is 80,000 into T. T is 1 year into 10 divided by 100. Okay. Now two zeros will get cancelled. Why? Because these are the numerator, this is the denominator, we can able to do the cancellation. Next, 800 into 10 into 1 divided by 1. Now 800 into 10, 8000 rupees. I is equal to 8000 rupees. Okay, A is equal to, now P plus I, total amount we need to find out, no? So principal amount plus what we got interest, simple interest. We should add principal amount 80,000 plus that interest 8,000. So it will becomes 88,000. Okay. Now this is for 1 year only. Next, for half year means 6 months. Interest on half year. This is 6 months, no? These 6 months we can convert into year. So half year. So principal amount, it will becomes this amount here in this part 1, this amount will becomes here principal amount 88,000. This is 10% rate of interest same. T is the 6 months, that is half year. Okay, now I is equals to same formula we should use and we should substitute. P is 88,000 into half year into 10 divided by 100. Now two zeros will get cancelled. 2 ones are 2 fives are 10. Cancellation with 2 table. So 2 ones are 2, 2 fives are 10. Okay, next 880 into 1 into 5. Okay, now 0, 8 fives are 40, 8 fives are 40. 40 plus 4, 44. Okay, so interest for half year 4,400 rupees. Okay, now the amount to be paid after 1 year 6 months, then it will amount we should add principal amount plus interest, this interest. Okay, so principal amount 88,000 plus simple interest I 4,400. Okay, now this is A1, 92,400. If you add these two values, you will get 92,400. This is the amount to be paid after 1.5 year. How much amount? 92,400. Now he has to pay compounded on every 6 months in 1.5 year. Means that here 3 time periods will be occurred. Yes or no? For one time period for 6 months. Here how many 6 months are there in 1.5 year? 3 6 months. yes or no? For 1 year, 6 months, 6 months, two times. For half year, 6 months. Okay, total 3 time periods it will be in 1.5 year. Okay, so we can consider n is equals to 3 time period. Okay, now r is equals to 10 by 2. It will becomes 5. Okay, now p is equal to 8000 principal amount. Now a is equals to p into 1 plus r by 100 whole power n. This is the formula we should remember. Okay, now 80,000 1 plus 5 by 100 whole power 3. Okay, here rate of interest 5 will know. So next 80,000, here you can take the LCM. Okay, now if you take the LCM, 1 in 100, 100 times it will go. So 1 into 100, 100 plus 100 in 100, 1 time only it will go. So 1 into 5, 5. Okay, 80,000 into 105 divided by 100 whole power 3. Okay, now you can do the cancellation. 520 is 100, 521 is 105. Okay, 80,000 into 21 by 20 whole power 3. 80,000 into 21 by 20 into 21 by 20 into 21 by 20. A2 is equals to this amount, 92,610 rupees. Okay, now difference between the amounts, A2 minus A1, 92,610, 92,400. Okay, A2 minus A1, this is 210 rupees. Okay, difference between the amounts, 210 rupees. Okay, I hope you understood. For more videos, subscribe my channel, support me. Don't waste your time. Those who are watching, you should write in your notebook and you should do the practice once again yourself, so that you can know whether you are getting or not. Very simple, just you have to find the interest on 1 year, next for 6 months, next 3 time periods will be in that 1.5 year. So that you can find the amount by using 3 conversion periods, n is equal to 3, so it will come. So the difference between the amounts you should take, that is the amount. Okay.